Howdy there, partners. Welcome back to Silverrun Forest. Still in December, snow's gone. I'm just trying to clear away any stumps out and see before these trees grow. And I think massive pile of stones there as well, aren't there? Add that to the list of chores. Killed off the grass. I've got a bit of a better view now about where all these 40 trees are going to be growing. No doubt some of them won't be in a good position. Somewhere around here. But there it is. ...47 kilos of ponderosa pine. I'm wondering whether to actually pave around this area. Oh, some eggs. Oh, good on you. But now the snow's clearing. Gonna head on down to sort out some sheep. Why not strike while the iron's hot? Which way am I going though? Somewhere that way. We can go off the track. Now, it would be nice to possibly nice and flat around here, isn't it? It would be quite nice to put in a decent sized sheep barn, but I think to start us off with, because we're literally scratching from nothing, we'll go for sort of one of the cheapest we can get. Something that looks rickety, like we've made it out of wood, out of the offcuts. Deadwood. Making use of the deadwood. Lovely little skyline vista. So, if I stand out in the middle, let's have a look. See, eventually we want to move down this way. Probably put a track in around there. It'd be quite nice to live near the lake though, wouldn't it, really? All the trees around there. Maybe have a sort of entrance in around here. Potential sort of shopping local farm produce area, and then we could maybe put fields in as well as a a lot of grass area, so I'm thinking maybe somewhere around here. But we are going to need wool. Tempted with cows as well, but we'd need straw. Too dear, too dear, too fancy. Can't remember what I've downloaded. Interesting. Not for us. Stick 50 of them, free range. Not the worst idea, free range. $30 of them for $5,000. $18 on that for 6.5. I have to say that almost looks a little bit in keeping with what we're planning. And 30 of them. First things first. As is always the golden rule, save in case it's wrong. Or do we have some free range? Just, no, I suppose you want them fenced because you're near a main road. That wouldn't be that sensible, would it? But we do want markers. So it is 50 of them. That's a lot more wool. Heading towards this angle for it. Yeah. And then we'll probably put a track in around here. Go up to there. And they will require water. What sort of track do we want? Gravel. I think we're looking at gravel. Looking good. Gonna have a look. Oh, we're gonna need something to transport water. Shouldn't need it really, because there's a rain runoff there, but and that opens very nice. So maybe we can pick up a cheap small bale. Or we can start farming with that. Somewhere to put bales around the back as well. Hello. Bit of storage around the back. This is absolute bargain for 5 grand. What's my pathway looking like? I'd better drive down that because I think it should probably be a bit bigger. Yeah, I think that will need to be a bit bigger. Let's make it bigger. Very nice. Room for a bit of grass to grow in between as well. A little bit of gravel on there. Help for when it snows, I suppose. Now that's posing the argument for the skid steer loader, isn't it? Yes, it is. But anyway, we need to check the sails. What's that? That would have been handy, actually, but nothing that we necessarily need right now. So we might need something to pick up water. Which, in all fairness, we need for both the greenhouse and the pigs as well. Moving the pigs down, I'm not so sure about at the minute. Still quite tempted to say we'll leave the decision of skid steer, wheel loader or telehandler. We'll leave that pretty much till the sail decides for us, basically. Now we'll test out getting onto our spot. works very well. Snow is coming again. To be fair, a decent sized farm building on here wouldn't be too bad. I'll have to have a word. See if there's anything old and cheap. Actually, what's just not that? That one. Silage, when's it at its best? The market buys it. And it's nearly at its best. Might go up a little bit more, but we can still sell some to get some money in. Which is very good. Right, water trailer. $3,000. $3,200. Milk as well, so we possibly could look at cows. But are we going to need more? Are they going to want more than 2,000 litres of water? I mean, I'm loving the look of that. That is homemade. Can it be picked up from... Can that hitch it up? Yes! Oh! I don't think this is... Here we go. Like an old western homestead. That's the maximum it will take. Oh. I don't want to take that tree down, but... if we need to... I won't be afraid to. Why did I drive the tractor away? I'm going to need it back for that. Sheeples will... we're not bothered about reproducing. But we do want wool. We don't need that much wool yet, because that's going to be a lot further off. So we can go with youngsters. So... three of each. Yes. Yes, yeah, I know, I've left it. Oh no, I left my tractor with the other. Don't fret. I'll go and fetch you some. Road down there as well. Maybe a little fence action as well. Not that much food either. Oh, we're doing well. Silage pit. Silage is pretty much at its best as well. Save before. Jeez. Is that the sort of thing that's gonna bleed through? Going to be a while before we need it, but yeah, I've used them, they bleed. So we'll probably go with the modded one with the back on it. And that is very ugly, so I mean, perfectly in keeping. With here. Backing onto it. Or should we go drive through? Maybe we should put it back over here then. There. I wasn't intending to buy that then, but... Path coming out across to around here. Bit of space there for other things. Fairly out the way, you could stick a decent sized barn in here. Maybe stick a house around this bit. Yeah, it's not too bad. It'll work. We've just brought the... I'm not sure if they're actually silage. Yep, they are silage. Brought the silage over to the market, as I believe this is where we sell them. Oh, £2,000 is a really good amount of money. I can't remember how many we had. But £2,000 is really good. For three of them. Before it gets dark, I want to find out how many do we reckon's here. £40, £50? I'm not even sure. I've got the two log transportation contracts. So I think I'll start trying that before it gets too dark. Selling and stuff, we can all, the moving of the other products we've got, we can do tomorrow because it'll still be December and a bit snowy. But that's... that's decent. That's really good. I want to try and make as much money before, or tonight, to pay off as much of the loan as possible. How much is the loan? $175,000. Okay. The pit's fairly good because it is sort of hidden, but it does look like a full-on man-made earthworks, doesn't it? What sort of sheds could we put in for a decent price? What's your best price? Start the beginning. None of these, they're too new and fancy. There's the old... stick the old barn in, but then it is a drive-through. We'd need small equipment to store in. We could pop one of them in to put equipment on. Ooh. Big old Quaznet. That's 32. Grand, that's not actually too bad. Drive through though, we don't particularly need. $10,000 for a machine shed's not too bad, is it? Put your tractors in. Seven off. That's pretty interesting. It's got a workshop. Is massive. Some decent options. Anyway, let's get the Ford and see how it fares with the logs. I've got to say, the Ford has surprised me. it can lift four of these. I mean, it does. There is a couple of moments where it's had a bit of a jitter out and thrown everything. But I don't think there's any reason to for us to be concerned about getting a replacement quickly. I think it does give us time to breathe. And there's a slightly, I don't know what it's going to be like now with this full, but strapping it onto there. What's the best route? Oh yeah, straight down. Oh, I've missed one. How did I miss that? Yeah, it'll certainly do in the short term until something else comes up. I wonder. I thought that might happen. Dope. I don't think we've had an accident or a crash or episode yet, have we? Hey. Oops. This could take a while. If I just rest it right on the top of those. Yeah, it looks decent. Leave the handbrake off. Straps are on. And away. Now obviously the fence good, but it's not going to be hitting its 39 mile an hour because it's pulling all this weight, but It is getting the job done. He says, as it sits in neutral. Maybe I might have to come back for the Ford. But then I've already worked out, you don't really want to be going too fast. Nice and steady. You see on the flat ground up to 16, 17. We'll follow this on to the point where we drop it off, just in case. Oh, in case I roll it and have to leave it there, but I do hope you've enjoyed the episode. If you have, please drop us a like. If you've not subscribed yet, please do. Everything's off the ground now. If you want to put any comments, feel free to put comments in the comments section. I hope the train don't come. Dizzy heights of 24 miles an hour. There we go. A nice productive episode that. Apart from parking on the state of it. Here we go. A bit of a squeal on it. And that's a quick 20 grand. Not quick, well. Certainly not to be sniffed at, which takes the debt down to 125k. I suppose next episode we'll find out how much we can get from the silage. But until then, thank you so much for watching, and bye for now.